Welcome back. We're glad you're watching The Business Show with me, Simon. Now, in case you're joining us for the first time, this show airs every Thursdays at 10 p.m. and the repeat is on Saturdays at 8 in the morning. So make a date and just learn something about how you can improve your business. Let's talk how to make money this week. And when someone tells you that the way information is perceived now is changing very fast because of technology, ideally they're right, yeah? But did you know that even if we moved away from what you would call traditional ways of communicating, there is a young group of people that is passing out creative messages for farmers in northern Uganda and also fighting domestic violence and discrimination amongst the disabled plus children. They say through this creative art, they are able to actually make real-time interventions into the challenges in society, but also for them, the future is bright and they are just a team of young people with a dream of making this country a better place. How to make money.
My name is Benjamin Wandera and I work with Urithi Studio. Urithi is a continuation from Mango Tree, former Mango Tree Educational Services, which used to deal in educational material for 2021. We pick up from there with a team of about seven and started the same venture. Now, what Urithi aims at is into communication and social change material. Any material that's aimed at improving the daily lives of a client is what we go for. Like it's, as we go through on, because we have very many companies that come to us, but how many emphasis is on social behavior change? How does the information affect the person on ground? How does it improve them? And how does it help them transist?
Okay, thank you for speaking to us. Just tell us a bit about why, of all possible business ideas, young people like you could choose to do this?
You know, as you go through life, that a lot of things that happen. However, at the end of the day, availability of information is also key to improving livelihood. For example, there's so much about, for example, farming, but what are the nitty-gritties about it? How do you break it down to the simplest form that a farmer down there can understand? For example, you may bring in all manuals and all this information, but it's not breaking it down in the right form. The information is as good as useless. So what we aim at is making the information as understandable as possible. So that what we usually do is that we involve the clients. We don't do this information alone. We involve the clients from this first step, second step, third step, all throughout the level, so that we come out with the information that's understandable and also attainable.
What makes this unique?
What makes this unique is because we co-create with the clients themselves. We don't just sit in the office and make information that we hope they will understand. We go directly to them, come up with the information and how it will suit them. Most of the information is tailored for the different communities. What will work here and what will work there because of the different problems. For example, for this client, as you can see, it's a comic about disability and inclusion. This is best suited for the clientele in South Sudan, and it may be applicable here, but the impact may be low. So for clients here, we do the same. We go down there, co-create with them, come up with data and information, which later is turned into information that they can end up using.
Okay. You talk about clients, and I'm thinking, who are your clients really, mostly? And for the years you've been, you say what, 2 years now?
We made money in existence, but however, most of the staff were under Mango Tree, so we just mainly transitioning and continuing what they used to do.
Okay, so what are some of the things you think you've done? What kind of impact have you created using this kind of platform?
Okay, for the biggest client we have, we're working with GADC, and we're working with soy and sesame. However, what we aim at is improving the farming practices throughout the value chain. That is from site selection, clearing, planting, harvesting, post-harvest handling, and also selling them. Well, the impact is through information that we have created, we've been able to affect the people and also improve livelihood through the material that we produce. And with different partners, we have seen actually a great improvement in the practices. For example, we've been doing farming material for soy and sesame. And after the training materials have reached the clientele, we have found that it has actually improved on the yield and also other farming practices throughout the value chain.
Okay, so your team of young people, and for the last about 1 year you've been doing this now.
Yes.
If someone asked you in the next probably 1 year, where do you see this company going? And do you think you'd want to grow it to have more young people join you?
Well, this is a useful company and very much growing the company. However, we need to take baby steps at this, since it's not really complex, but it takes a lot of conceptualization, ideologies. So this is something that we're building on, and in the next 5 years, we hope to achieve that information out there is useful. Not in abundance, but it's useful to the client.
Okay.
Most of us have. Our previous working experience has all brought us here, so we've owned our experience in doing this. This is something that we love, and this is something that we're willing to actually take on the next number of years. So it doesn't matter if it's 10 years, 20 years from now, we shall be doing something that we love, and this is it. So what I can say is that we shall push doing this, and patience is one of our virtues.
So probably one of those obvious questions is, what are some of the challenges that I involved in this kind of work, which I really think is quite tedious?
Well, I would look at the challenge, but information keeps on changing, and you find that you have to tailor material to the satisfaction of the client. However, this is something you do over and over again. You end up doing things almost 10 to 20 times that you come up with that one perfect piece that will be useful to them. So if you're not good at that, you may actually end up disagreeing with the client, but this is something I'm used to, and this is something I'm carrying on doing. This that information comes through a lot of scrutiny and also planning. For example, that has gone through almost like about 4 phases of visualization, and helps depicts what happens at the lower stage. For example, for the client in South Sudan, and I'm talking about disability, how would a child enrolling in school disability affect them? What could they aim at in the next, for example, 10 to 20 years? So we came up with material, these illustrations, like that child with one leg being taken into school, talks about inclusion and what they hope to achieve. So one chart shows the child at school. Second part, child is enrolled at school. Third section, the child is getting to the school system and answering questions. And the fourth is more like the victory round, whereby they're graduating. Simple information, but at the end of the day, it has a big impact.
My name is Nambaje Sandra. I'm the production lead for Ethi Studios. And what we normally do, when the client comes in, after the first stages from the offices and the computer, they send a sample to us, which we make as this. We make it in English so that we give the client a final product to see and approve if it's exactly what they had asked for. Then they bring them back in the company. Then we produce as many copies as possible.
All right, so you talk about it coming from the computer and then to this. So when it comes here, what do you start on?
What do we start on? We have a stencil, which we start on, which is later on given to the artists to sketch, make illustrations, blank illustrations without colors. After it's done sketched, it's brought to the next team, which put in the colors. So we use 5 primary colors of the markers. So these are the main markers we use. And from these, we have the different colors. As you can see, we have brown on it. There are some charts with lemon green or orange and all the other colors. So these are the main markers we use. And then we have a marker. We get one old marker that has no ink in it. We put spirit inside, so it fades the color to give it harmony. And that's how we make the shades of the color.
Right, so looking at the raw material, call it raw material or whatever it is, yes. Why do you choose to use this and not vanillas per se?
We choose to use the grain tuck because it's long lasting, weather friendly, and it catches more people to use it. Why? It's not common on the market, and most people find it really hard to tell that we have used markers to write and draw even the smallest image. So that makes it more useful to the client, because there are not many companies that use the grain tuck.
Is it a bit costly to buy this then?
It depends. I would really say it depends on the market, how the price goes.
So I see you have a team of young guys and ladies trying to paint and stuff. How do you even get them? Must they have studied a particular course, or how do they even apply to work with you?
We do not really get people who have studied a course in designing. We go for teenagers or for graduates who have just left school and they're looking for what to do. So we train them and teach them how it is done, how it's drawn, what are the specifics that we need. And once they pass that level, we start giving them work to do.
So about how long does it take for a trainee to start and be able to put out something that is final and the client can?
It depends on someone's capability. One person can take a day, the other person can take 2 weeks, the other person can take 4 days. It depends on what effort and the capability the person has put in. Yes.
So I've seen you you have some translations as well.
Yes.
What impact does that create?
This helps the person on the ground to understand it much more better. The people who are not educated and cannot read English, but they can read something in their local language. So like this, it is in Acholi. So someone from Gulu can really read the word and understand it compared when I give it to the person in English. So they're able to relate to the information on the chart in their local language than in English.
Okay.
Yes.
So of the content that you produce, what are some of the most the common sectors or industrial areas that most clients look into?
Agriculture and early childhood materials.
And why is that so?
Learning how to count the alphabet, 1 from 10, 1 to 100, learning parts of a flower, depending on the clientele.
Some interesting conversation there. And you know, like we keep saying on this program, if you step out to do something that is unique. If you do something that everyone else is doing, you might have to be super better than all of them, which means maybe your branding should be much better, your packaging should be better, and your marketing strategy should be better as well. Strategy is one of the things that most young people don't really pay attention to, and even the businesses. Someone walks up to you and asks you, I need funding. So you ask them, how do you plan to make this thing work? What is your strategy as a business person? Those are some of the things you need to pay attention to. Explain to someone that if I get this fund or this funding in 2022, by the next 2 years, we're able to post this, we'll employ this number of people. And it must be real stuff, not imaginations. Don't speak as a business person simply because you want money. Be realistic. Look at the times, look at the project, and see how feasible it is. And is it a viable venture that can make that money? Let's talk personal finance tips for this week. And Charles Katongole from Standard Chartered Bank takes us through why you need insurance. Now, whereas most of you think insurance is a thing for cars, it could actually save everything about your assets. Personal finance.
Charles, please introduce yourself. Welcome to this segment.
Thanks, Cynthia. Charles Katongole, Head of Financial Markets with Standard Chartered Bank.
Fantastic. So, Charles, we are here today because you are an expert, you are a thought leader, you've been doing this for years, and we are talking investment, okay? Now, we want to tackle the particular issue of insurance, and I know that less than 1% of people are insured, but it's an investment vehicle, isn't it?
Yeah, it's both investment and risk.
Okay, tell me more about that.
Well, from our personal perspective, I guess the most basic insurance that we use is health insurance. And I have to admit, that's paid by the employer, but it's one of the key benefits that we get. I have sat with friends and just a mere, okay, it seems mere until you have to pay. But when you get into a hospital with a sick child and they bring that bill, then you start wondering how you'd manage that. Now, the health insurance that's paid for by the insurer, you can actually also pay for it individually. It comes in to save quite a bit. And I think that's something we can all, at least for the parents, can attest to. When you get into that hospital and the child is coughing like mad, and they bring you a 300,000 bill and you're thinking,
just the
okay.
Example you're using of a child coughing is even better. Imagine going to have a baby.
Exactly.
And you have to go for surgery.
Exactly.
And the bill is like 30 million unplanned for. Yet you could. Isn't it possible to save like little 50,000?
No, you can. You can. Because the way insurance is now structured, and the good thing is it's also sold within banks. So you have very many outlets in which to actually get cover. Or insurance. So the way it's structured, you can either pay the premium, which is now you buying that protection. You can pay it annually, or you can pay it in slices on a monthly basis, depending on who your provider is. As I was giving you, the first example for me was health, and I see that benefit, because you walk in and you're not worried about getting treatment. And because the providers are all over the place, it works. I've also had incidents where motor vehicle, which is common that we see. I know many of us are forced to get the third party, but the comprehensive is also available and it's quite useful where you get into a fix, you have an accident, maybe not necessarily your fault or could be yours for whatever reason. And to fix the car now, you have to fork out a huge chunk to kind of get you back to where you were before the incident. I think what insurance does for you is kind of set a base below which you don't fall, because you're risk participating. All of us within this room putting our money together in the event that one of us has a problem, instead of you having to pull from your pocket, the rest of us chip in. So that's really the way I would look at insurance. Now, it goes further. You, as I said, you can look at health, you can look at the asset protection, but even now, you can even mitigate against, there's education where you can mitigate against future events that could be adverse to you and your family. So in the event, God forbid, touch wood, anything happens to me, my children would still have the insurance company paying for them fees. Yeah, and that will ensure that they continue on that journey. Many of us think it's a luxury, but I don't think, because the one thing that's certain, as I've said, is change. Now, if you have cover at the back of it all, it doesn't hurt as much. If, as I said, God forbid, I'm not here, my children would still continue going to school. And many of us, the human being is a very interesting person. We want to aim for the largest bit, but we don't want to build it up. We just want to start with, can I get school fees for my university child? Now, how much would that cost? But you don't have to cover everything. I could say, fine, can I cover 20% of those fees? In the event anything happened to me, they don't have to look for that 20%. Yeah, and now there's a way in which if you go to a bank, and we do it as Tanchat here pretty well, we can structure for you an investment that actually pays for those premiums. Yeah, so you build a fixed income portfolio, you buy a couple of bonds, the income or the coupon of those bonds then pays for their insurance.
Really?
Yeah, so in essence, you're earning on your investment, but also getting protection. So those products are now available.
This particular part.
Yeah.
So I buy a bond of 100,000 like you earlier said in the earlier segment.
Yes.
And then I'm supposed to earn probably like after 6 months.
Yeah, let's just give a figure, 20,000, okay. That you're earning off your bond.
Uh-huh.
So I use the 20,000 mm-hmm. to pay a premium to get me cover. So you have a child and probably newly born. You don't know what the cost of education would be in 20 years when the kid is going into university. Near term, you probably feel you can still work, jobs are there, and you can manage within this space. But you don't know what will happen in 20 years. So you buy your bond, it's paying you 20,000 every 6 months. Go to your bank, ask if you can buy an education policy. Yeah, that.
In our case, Educare.
Educare for Stanchart. Where your premium is 20,000. Mm-hmm. So your bond pays you the 20,000, the bank pays the 20,000, builds that insurance product for you, probably covering whatever portion for your kid's education.
And you actually earn interest, don't you?
Yeah. So even from the policy itself, they do pay interest. It's much lower because of whatever that terms they are throwing in, if they're protecting you as well. So you can see how you're moving from investing and bundling that up with cover to protect yourself against those uncertainties that we can guarantee will happen.
Thank you, Simon. Looking at the currency market this week, the Uganda shilling has continued to strengthen against the dollar, largely on inflows coming in from offshore. The local unit has traded below the 3,800 level last seen in month. But currency traders say the appreciation bias is expected to be short-lived on account of economic variables such as inflation, now at 10.7%, that paints a bleak picture going forward. A look at the stock market this week, weekly market turnover declined to about 48 million, representing a 96% drop from the previous trading week. And then total volumes traded declined to about 1.4 from 7.6 million shares traded the previous week. Meanwhile, during the trading week, the MTN share price declined marginally by 0.05%, while other counters at the stock remained relatively unchanged. That has been it from the stock and currency market this week. My name is Ali Toha. See you next week.
So a few months ago, if anyone told you by December the fuel prices would be at about 5,000, there is just no way you would believe them, because look, at the time everything looked skyrocketing, and at one point guys actually said by December we'll be paying 10k for a liter of fuel. Thank God somehow things are working, and of course with the installation that has started of Oil Rich in the Kingfisher, there is now hope that yes, maybe by 2025, like it said, we'll be able to see a fast drop here. And for every business person, the answer question is at what point then do we start experiencing a low rate on fuel prices? Yep. So let's then run you through the different cities and how they're faring on fuel prices. There you have it. Hope you learned one or two things. Opportunities are like buses for business person. There is always another one coming at the next station. If a client walks up to you and they're not able to take your product, don't give up. Settle back. Look at something different that you can do. There's a second opportunity coming, and make sure when it comes, you take it. Don't miss the business clinic on Tuesdays. Yes, that is at 7:30 on the rush hour. With me, Simon, as we discuss the topics that affect your business and offer solutions from the different experts. We'll be back next week, and from me and the team, we'll see you soon. Bye-bye.